I'm Rob Reeg. I run technology globally for MasterCard. My organization and title is President, MasterCard Technology and Operations.
So why is technology so important to MasterCard? Because surely you're a credit card company.
Yeah, and that's the common thing most people think. They think of MasterCard as a payments company and a brand. And in actuality, what underpins all that is our technology. So as we start to really delve into that and help tell the story of why we're a technology company, I think people start to see that with the innovations that we're bringing to the forefront.
Okay. So why, on the back of that, why is innovation so important to MasterCard?
Well, we started a focused organization to look at innovation, make that their full-time job. And it's really only a handful of people, and it's a virtual organization with a MasterCard lab in Singapore, a MasterCard lab here in Dublin, MasterCard lab in the US. And it's an organization that works virtually and pops up where innovation needs to occur locally. The idea behind this, when Gary Flood and I set this up with our CEO Ajay Banga in 2010, the idea was not to have 15, 20 people thinking of all the good ideas, but getting 15 or 20 people to help the rest of the company generate good ideas.
Okay. So, obviously, you're coming up with these new products. How are you going to bring these products to the less developed parts of the world, the Africa and Southeast Asia, South America sort of areas?
In some of the innovations we're doing, it's actually easier to go to emerging markets because they don't have a built-up infrastructure that you may have to work through. So things like prepaid cards as a way to get people moving into financial inclusion, that's a much easier path in emerging markets than it is development markets.
Okay. Now, obviously, one of the big issues with any kind of financial things is the security. Is crime perhaps the biggest innovating driving force for innovation in security, do you find?
I don't think crime is the
it's
major driver,
crime.
But it is a driver. And if you go back to our mission to grow, diversify, and build off our infrastructure that we have in place, the key tenet of that we always look at is safe, simple, and smart. And safe, we want to own. We want to be the owner of the safe trademark in that. And to do that, you've got to stay ahead of everybody else that's trying to do things for the wrong reasons.
Because obviously the antivirus industry is driven by the virus writers, and I guess you're being driven maybe by the fraudsters and the hackers.
Yeah, it's a constant battle. It's something that we invest heavily in every single year, every single day. It's an area where we participate greatly with governments and security agencies, as well as our competitors, because this is an issue for the industry, not for any one brand.
Sure. Now, how do you, obviously MasterCard has been going nearly 50 years, how do you respond to disruptive technologies in your sort of area, such as PayPal and such like that? How do you address things like that?
I look at them as competition is always good. It's going to make you better. And so when someone comes up with a great idea, whether it's a tool like a dongle fitting on an iPhone that makes merchant acceptance much easier, it's up to us to say, how do we make that, bring that in and use it as a way to generate and bring transactions onto the MasterCard network? I think you have to look at it as a very positive thing, competition.
Okay, that's good. Now we're moving towards, with NFC in devices, wallets and stuff. How far away do you think we are from almost universal adoption of technology, something like that?
Yeah, we actually had this question a little earlier with some of the group. It's interesting. I don't think there's one date that the whole world will adhere to, but you're going to see it in pockets. Some markets are going to be much further along. And Ann Carnes talked about Turkey and the receptivity of Turkey and how they're leveraging phone-type products. They're moving very fast. I actually think the U.S. is much slower than that. Mm-hmm. The physical card has a built-up infrastructure that's going to take longer to overcome. So I think you'll see Gary Flood kind of talks about it in 3, 5, and 7 year chunks, that you'll start to see the world evolve, and places like Turkey maybe sooner rather than later.
Okay. Now, in one of the presentations earlier, you commented that only 15% of transactions worldwide are electronic. How are you going to persuade those people who are still paying with cash or with check? How are you going to convert them to pay electronically?
I think a lot of it has to do with acceptance. So how do we, for small ticket items, how do we help people and banks and merchants and consumers overcome the issue of always carrying coins around in their pocket? We talked about that. That's not always the most easy way to do it, but in some cases there are barriers to getting in there, whether it's infrastructure or technology. I think just over time you see this natural progression. People want access to their money when they want it, and that's not always an easy thing to do when you're cash based.
Now, we've seen quite a few of the new apps you've got in development today.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of them are about using people's shopping habits and history and whatever. How have you found people that are happy to share that very personal data with merchants? How happy are people to do that?
A lot of merchants already collect a significant amount of data. What we do in our data collection is it's not personalized. We don't have a person's name and address and that kind of demographic information. But what we do have is billions of transactions that we can analyze and look at patterns. And so we've got a group of mad scientists who sit back there and look at those patterns and come up with solutions on how can banks or merchants leverage that.
Okay. Now, following up on that with all your technology, what are the sort of technologies that you've seen coming up lately that have really excited you personally?
Well, a lot of people talk about cloud technology and the computer environment. And I was talking to an analyst and he said, you guys, MasterCard, you're really a cloud. And so a lot of people haven't thought of us as a cloud provider, but that's really, really what we are. A bank comes in, hooks up to us, they're part of the MasterCard cloud. They don't have to worry about where I'm doing processing, where the data center is located, how that transaction is getting routed, because we're doing that for all their behalf. So I think cloud technology and how we can leverage cloud computing within our private cloud we have for the banks is a really an interesting step that we'll take.
Okay. And one sort of final question. What would you say is the next biggest obstacle for MasterCard as a whole in terms of whether it's shopping or what have you?
The next biggest obstacle.
Is it user adoption? Is it security and combating fraud? Or
I'll speak to it from a technology standpoint. Gary Flood and Ann may have different answers than this. But for me, security and safety is the key element. If we can be the product that provides the safest, simplest, smartest way to pay, so from a consumer standpoint, they feel confident they can use it, that the merchant feels like there's value to them in accepting the card, and the bank feels like it strengthens their relationship with the cardholder, That's what we strive for.
Okay.
I mean, that's the genesis of this whole facility here in Dublin. Was we bought a company called Orbiscom that was focused on those type of control tools that they could give to a cardholder or safety. So I think it just means we're going to keep investing in that area.
This is a very final question.
Okay.
Obviously, the iPhone 5 came out a few weeks ago. Everybody, analysts were predicting it would have NFC. Some phones have NFC, which you are starting to make use of. Were you in any way disappointed that something as mass market as the iPhone now doesn't yet have NFC?
I was a little disappointed, but I know Apple's going to get there. The NFC's just such a convenience factor that people are demanding it.